Now, these three students, we are going to give you identities of them also. One of them is JNU Student Union President Aishe Ghosh, and they're going to be questioned at 11 a.m. This is an interesting development, Ashutosh, and possibly will also help in identifying all those who are behind the violence. But give us a sense of who these three students are. It's interesting that the police has chosen to question them in the campus, in the JNU campus itself.
Well, there is already almost a police camp inside the JNU campus. One wing that is guarding the administrative wing following the Supreme Court order, and another who is also conducting an investigation simultaneously inside the campus. And Aishe Ghosh, being a student of JNU, and since the academics are going to start from today, the Delhi police doesn't want to take anything or anything from the opposition camp that look, the students, instead of joining their academics, are being asked to appear before the crime branch for the probe. So perhaps you're looking at that aspect. The Delhi police will question and inquire about those three suspects, as Delhi police say, including Aishe Ghosh, inside the campus at 11 a.m. what we are hearing from our sources.
Okay, Ashutosh, do stay on with us. We're going to need your inputs on other stories as well. But sticking to the face-off and the stir that we've been witnessing in the Jawaharlal Nehru University, one of the biggest bone of contentions was with regards to the fee hike. Moving on to a controversy that's broken out. This is over a BJP leader, in fact, triggering this particular row over his book, which compares Prime Minister Modi with Shivaji Maharaj. The book was launched at the BJP headquarters in New Delhi on Sunday. Shiv Sena leader Sanjay Raut has criticized the book, calling it an abuse on Maharashtra and Marathi people. Lashing out at the BJP leader Jay Bhagwan Goel, the author of the book, Raut added that he is the same person who attacked the Maharashtra Sadan in Delhi. The book also drew criticism from Maha Aghadi partners, NCP and the Congress, who termed it an insult to the ideals of the Maratha king. Meanwhile, BJP's Rajya Sabha MP Chhatrapati Sambhaji Raje, who is also a descendant of the warrior king, demanded a ban on the book. He said that nobody can be compared to Chhatrapati Shivaji.
Shivaji Maharaj ke karyakal mein wo bahut bade great raja the aur aaj ke zamane mein Narendra Modi ji पंत प्रधान के नाते सबको साथ ले जाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. मुझे लगता है कि इसमें कोई किसी ने राजनीति करने की आवश्यकता तो नहीं है, लेकिन जो लेखक ने जो इसी तरह का कंपेरिजन किया है इसे मैं सहमत नहीं हूँ. लेकिन दोनों भी नेता ग्रेट नेता है और इसीलिए मुझे लगता है कि ऐसी तुलना करना ठीक नहीं है.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की मानसिकता जो कुंठित मानसिकता है इससे निश्चित तौर पर दिखाई देती है. जिसका जितने भी कड़े शब्दों में जिसकी भर्त्सना की जाए उतना कम है. भारतीय जनता पार्टी ये शिवाजी महाराज के विचारों पे चल नहीं सकती. शिवाजी महाराज के विचारों के खिलाफ वो है, तो ये जो प्रयास है इसकी भर्त्सना हम करते हैं.
Mustafa Sheikh is joining us live from Mumbai with more details on this. Mustafa, clearly the BJP is under a lot of pressure to go ahead and withdraw this book, even from within. There are several BJP leaders who are also saying that this kind of a comparison is controversial and unnecessary.
Well, of course, and the descendants of Shivaji just recently joined the BJP, Shivendra Yadav Bhosle, before the Maharashtra elections, and he would also be in a tough spot. And the problem for the BJP looks like the book was inaugurated at BJP head office in New Delhi. So the BJP cannot really cut off its ties with the book because he's a BJP leader, the person who has authored the book. There have been also complaints, already police complaint filed in Nandanwan police station of Nagpur by a Congress spokesperson saying that the book hurts religious sentiment, it should be banned. Sanjay Raut from Shiv Sena has yesterday launched an all-out attack on the book. So yes, the BJP in Maharashtra and on national level will be under pressure on what stand they take on this book. Back to you.
Okay, Mustafa, thanks for getting us those updates. We'll have to wait and watch to see whether the BJP actually gives in to some of that pressure and decides to withdraw the book.